today we'll going good to morning. See okay today we're going to see about modeling of action potentials. Okay, we're going to see modeling of action potential. Okay, so you remember how the action potentials basically work. Okay, just a recap of what happens in an action potential. So we remember that our cell by its very default, it has more amount of chlorine ion inside the cell. Okay, more amount of chlorine ions inside the cell and less amount of sodium inside, and whereas you have more amount of sodium outside the cell. Outside the cell you have more amount of sodium. Okay, also inside it K plus is more, potassium is more. Okay, so outside also there will be chlorine, outside also there will be potassium. Okay, but outside of the cell is having more sodium, inside of the cell is having more chlorine ions. Because of this mechanism, if you measure the potential with respect to the inside and outside, if you record the potential, it will be in the order of minus around 60 to minus 90 millivolts. So this is what we call it as resting potential. Okay, this is called, we call it as resting potential. Fine. And we also saw that whenever an stimulus occurs, whenever you have a stimulus occurs, nerve impulse, a stimulus occurs, temporarily the membrane nature changes, thereby sodium ions infuse inside. Sodium ions infuse inside. This infusion of sodium ions inside the cell makes the cell momentarily, makes the cell momentarily positive with respect to the outside. So for the moment alone, it will be more positive with respect to outside. This condition, so at this point if you measure the potential, it's a relative potential, okay, with respect to outside. So inside is more positive with respect to outside. This condition, it measures to around some 20 millivolt. This condition is called as action potential. So that's what we have seen already. Okay, so just we are reviewing the action potential. And again, after the stimulus has passed, so suddenly you have more amount of sodium ions inside. These sodium ions, if it has to transmit outside, it will take more time. Okay, to remove, make the transmission faster, you have our super thing, sodium potassium pump. This pump actually pushes out all the sodium atoms outside, so that it will be very fast to reverse back to the original. Okay, so initially the cell is in a resting state, or you call it as a polarized state. When the stimulus comes, it is action potential, that is called as the depolarized state. Again it will move down to repolarized state. So it is in polarized, depolarized, and it becomes repolarized. Okay, so this peak potential is called as action potential. That's we have seen already. Okay, so for many years scientists have been identifying methods to study about this action potential, how these action potentials originate in the body, how to record it, what is the kind of mechanism that action takes place inside this action potential. Okay, so there are several models that comes in this picture. So of that, the most famous one is Oakley's model, Oakley and Huxley's model. Okay, so this is the most famous model for explaining about the action potential, even the first type of model that explain about the mechanism of your action potential. So what is the original model given by this person? Okay, this is actually based upon a technique called voltage clamp technique. voltage clamp technique. So what is this technique? Okay, basically we know that if you take our cells, I told that sodium will be going inside, potassium will be going outside, chlorine will be coming inside. Okay, all these things, how these ions move in and out of the cell. Okay, if you see how the ions move in and out of the cell, you have something called as gates. The cells have gates. For example, there will be sodium gates, there will be potassium gates, there will be chlorine gates. Okay, so they are highly selective to that particular ion. Okay, so basically when a sodium ion comes in, there will be an associated protein. That protein will attach to the structure, the protein will attach to the cell. Once it attached, this cell will open, something like a key. So the cell is closed, so the particular sodium channel, if it has to open, a particular protein attaches. Okay, when a particular protein attaches, that cell wall will open. Okay, so there are this protein mechanism is nothing but it can be a voltage gated, it can be a current gated, or it can depend upon some site of protein things attaching. Okay, so it is voltage gated, means whenever it exceeds a voltage level, so that particular channel will open. So it is current gated channel, like that we have different kinds of channel. Okay, so basically via these channels only the ions will enter into the particular cell and it will be moving out of the cell. That's a basic technique. Okay, now basically your sodiums are voltage gated channels. Sodium, you have voltage gated channels. Through these channels only it will be entering. Okay, I'm just explaining what is the voltage clamp technique, because Auguly and Huxley use the voltage clamp technique to understand the action potential mechanism. So first we'll see what is the voltage clamp technique, then we'll just go into the actual Auguly and Huxley model. Okay, so basically if you see into the voltage clamp technique, so originally these studies were not conducted on humans. These studies were conducted on squid, you know, squid. Okay, so squids, so in the Erol. Okay, squid, that's called as Erol in Tamil. Okay, squid, in that you have axon, adoda it has a giant axon in the squid. This is most commonly used for testing. Okay, because the action potential is almost similar to that of the human beings. Okay, so they use squid giant axon, okay, for their study. So we have the squid giant axon. We use a intracellular electrode, and we have an extracellular electrode, that is electrode inside the cell, and you have an electrode outside the cell. Okay, so these two are measured, that is you are measuring the membrane potential. That's what we do, no? Normally to measure the membrane potential, you will be having one electrode inside the cell, one electrode outside the cell. So the difference of these two is the membrane potential. This membrane potential is measured. Here is the very interesting catch. You'll use a feedback amplifier. Okay, we'll be using a feedback amplifier. So what this feedback amplifier will do is, here is a very interesting part. Here you're going to have a command voltage. Okay, command voltage. Here you're going to have a command voltage. I'll tell you what is the importance of this command voltage. Remember, you have studied about superposition theorem. In our circuits, we have studied about superposition theorem. Okay, what happens in a superposition theorem? In a superposition theorem, superposition theorem is used in electrical networks. Suppose in a circuit, if you have multiple voltage sources, say V1, you have multiple voltage sources. Okay, So what we can do is to study the effect of each and every source. What they will do is they will place one particular voltage source at a time. They will remove the other sources. For example, if you are removing a voltage source, you will be short circuiting. If you have a current source, it will be open circuiting. So you will have one source at a time and you find what is the current. Okay, first you will see the effect of V1, then effect of V2, then effect of V3. Then you will take the algebraic sum of these three to get the effect of total current. Okay, that's what we have seen. That is, superposition theorem states that when you have multiple sources, you take one voltage source at a time, find the current, then take the algebraic sum, it will be the effect of all the three. Okay, in a similar manner, in our cell also, there are different voltage gated channels. You have sodium channel, you have potassium channel, you have chlorine channels. Okay, so you cannot study about all the things at the same time. So what they do is that to choose one channel at a time. Okay, how to choose one channel at a time? The thing is, you can choose the appropriate voltage. So sodium will have a different voltage, potassium will have a different voltage, chlorine will have a different voltage. So choose the appropriate voltage that is required. Okay, so according to the voltage, that particular channel alone will be opening. So you can study about that particular channel alone. So the idea is, here the command voltage serves this purpose. So according to the channel you require, you have to set your command voltage. Okay, so when you set your particular command voltage, what happens is that whatever be the membrane potential, it will be compared with your command voltage. Okay, the difference of that, it is amplified. The difference is amplified. That amount of current is given to your axon. Okay, so this is a current passing electrode. Okay, it is a current passing electrode. Okay, so whatever be the voltage level that you require, according to that, it's like your feedback amplifier. See, this is a feedback amplifier. This is the actual membrane potential that is measured. You, according to the command potential that you require, the difference, that error, it will be giving as a current, so that in that particular action, you try to make a particular current level to be dominant, so that that particular gated channels will open. So you can study about that gated channels alone. That's the idea behind voltage clamp technique. Okay, so you are clamping a voltage, you are fixing. Clamp means you fix a level. You fix a level. Okay, you are trying to fix a particular voltage level so that you study about that channel alone in more detail. That is the idea behind voltage clamp technique. Okay, so what we do is that by choosing the appropriate command voltages, you can choose which channel to be open. Which channel to be open? That's the idea. Okay, so now I'll just tell you the Oakley-Huxley model. So the actual model, HH model for neuronal communication, is given like this. So whenever you have a cell, it is going to develop some potential. So storage of the potential, I'm going to represent by a capacitance. Then you have three primary things that play a very important role in action potential. One is the sodium, second one is the potassium, third one is the chlorine. Okay, so I'm going to represent the flow of current, particularly through the sodium channel, by a factor called conductance. Okay, I'm not representing resistance. Conductance is a reciprocal of resistance. So when the resistance is low, your conductance will be large. Okay, here it is represented by conductance. I'm putting it as conductance. And the potential, and the potential is ENA. Okay, this is for sodium channel. Similarly, I have GK. This is for potassium. The membrane potential is EK. Okay, similarly for chlorine, this is for GCl, the conductance of the chlorine. Again, I have ECl. So this is the actual potential model given by HH, that is Oakley and Huxley model, where they are representing the conductance in each of the channels. So if you write using Kirchhoff voltage law, so you can just put C into, suppose the potential is V, here it is ground, okay. So C into dV by dt plus gNA into V minus ENA plus GK into V minus EK plus GCL into V minus ECL is equivalent to zero. This is the equation. Okay. So we try to solve this equation. This is our differential equation connected to this one. So C into dV by dt plus gNA into V minus ENA plus GK into V minus EK plus GCL into V minus ED. This is a potential equation. Okay. We try to solve this equation. Before that, we need to know what are the values of gNA. These are all constant conductance. Okay. So what is the actual inference from the model is, if you happen to see, initially the cell is in a resting state. Once the stimulus comes, the sodium ions move inside. Because of the movement of the sodium ions, you have an action potential that you already seen. Okay. Now we'll see what is the conductance. If you see what is the effect of conductance, when sodium moves inside, okay, or I can put it as the sudden influx of sodium current. That is, current of sodium is increasing. When the current will increase? Only if the resistance to the sodium is decreased. Okay. Or resistance, I can put it reversal as conductance. When the conductance of sodium is high, your current will flow. Okay. So if you plot for sodium conductance at this point, sodium conductance will also be I. Okay. So what is this kind of feedback you can see? This kind of feedback, that is, whenever there is an action potential, that is when a stimulus comes in, your output voltage increases. Again, the conductance also increases. Okay. This is a kind of positive feedback. Okay. When the conductance increases, the voltage also increases. This is positive feedback. Okay. Whereas, when the cell wants to come back to its normal operation, all the potassium will move out, all the sodium will move out. There you'll have the negative feedback. Okay, again the current will fall. Okay, so you'll have a positive as well as a negative feedback mechanism inside this action potential model. Okay, similarly this is for sodium, and actually the potassium will be slightly different. This is GK. That is the conductance of the potassium atom. Okay, so I'll give you some more equations that are prescribing to this one. So I'm just taking it from the book. Physiological Control Systems by Michael Say Kuo. Okay. This is the model we are seeing, Oakley-Huxley model. That's the model we are seeing actually now. Okay. A very interesting fact that is given here is, see, the values of the potential is represented here. Okay, so for example, potassium has minus 77 millivolt, whereas the sodium is 50 millivolt and the chlorine is minus 54 millivolt. Okay, and the respective conductance, so conductance GK, GNA are in the order of 1 microfarad per centimeter square. Okay, So that's the equation, and this is what your GNA is given by. GNA, it depends upon two factor. One is a M factor and another is a H factor. M is something called as the activation function. So activation function is responsible for sudden rise, okay, whatever the positive feedback. So that positive feedback is your M. H keeps track of the negative feedback. Okay, so the sodium depends upon all these factors. Okay, so this is the actual model of your thing. Okay, so again you have because M and H are the state variables. One is for activation, another one is for inactivation. That is positive feedback and negative feedback. Again, the state variables are given by first order dynamic equations. Okay, so these are the state equations. Okay, we need not worry much about it, but these equations are very much required when you want to simulate the entire system. Okay, again, still we are seeing about first this is sodium. With respect to sodium, for calculating M and H, okay, so original model is, see here, this is our original model. For this I require GK, GNA and GCL. To get the GNA, this is the equation. G, capital GNA is a constant of proportionality. It depends upon these two factors, M and H. To get your M and H, we have to use these, we have to start, we have to solve for these two state equations. Okay, the state equations for just a minute. Okay, these are the state equations for M and H, particularly for sodium. Particularly for sodium, see, GNA is 120 millimo per centimeter square. Okay, further, now once you solve for M and H, once you solve for M and H, you require two constants again, alpha M and beta M. Okay, these two are given by these values. This is alpha M value. These are all constants values. Again, see, all these are dependent on the voltage. These are voltage dependent quantities. Okay, this is dependent upon the voltage. So alpha M and beta M. Again, for potassium, you have alpha H and beta H. This is the potassium representation, and finally you have for chlorine. Okay, so all these things you have to represent by equations. These equations we'll be trying to simulate. I'll just show you the simulation. I'll just open MATLAB. Okay. So this is the Oakley-Atchley model. Okay, see, the resting potential, we take it as minus 68 millivolts. Potassium is minus 74 millivolts. Sodium is 54.2 millivolts. Okay, so we conductance values, K values and N values, and the initial parameters you have to give. Okay, and all the expressions I have shown you, alpha N, beta N, alpha M, beta M, alpha H, beta H. That is for calculating GK, GNA and GCL. These parameters are given. Based on that, so you will be plotting the sequence. You will plot the actual equation. Okay. And you will be calculating the different currents. So you will calculate the sodium current, potassium current and the total ionic current. And finally, you will substitute in the original equation. Because it is a differentiated equation, we are using like this, delta T. We are actually trying to solve the first year using derivatives, Euler's first order approximation. To solve this derived equation, we are using first order approximation to solve for it. Okay. So with that, we will be able to simulate your exact action potential. We will see the simulation. Okay, so this is your action potential. You are able to see it. You are able to see both the graphs.
No, sir. No, sir.
Just a minute, just a minute. You're able to see now?
Yes, sir.
Sir.
So this is your voltage things, okay? This is your overall voltage transmission in a particular simulated neuron. And this is the conductance of potassium and sodium. This is the conductance of potassium and sodium, okay? So how to simulate for different cases, fine? So it is slightly different from the original graph that I explained. In this graph, potassium, okay, this is your sodium, okay, it's correct. First you have the sodium. So almost when the sodium is about when sodium is about to decrease, then only the potassium tries to move. It tries to find a balance, okay? So these two are primarily responsible for your action potential. Even though chlorine is also important, but action potential, in the perspective of action potential, the thing that is more important is sodium and potassium, particularly sodium. You can see the sodium conductance very much matches with your voltage. It is almost matching with your voltage, okay? So these kind of simulation models will help you about understanding the different gated channels and how they work, okay? So after Oakley and Huxley model, you have quite number of other models which explain about the conductance, about the mechanism of action potential, okay? So we are not, one model is sufficient for our study, fine?